What happens when over 400 teenagers from 21 churches representing 12 states and 2 countries are brought together under God for 7 days of service, worship, and fellowship? What happens when those teenagers trade in their everyday lives of cell phones, iPods, and air conditioning to step out of their comfort zones and live with strangers and work in temperatures that reach 100 degrees by noon? What happens when these young people choose to connect with one another, face the journey ahead, and serve the Lord in Jesus' name? Something amazing happens. Truth is discovered, lives are changed, strangers become family, and in the midst of all the fun, adventure, and excitement, the voice of God is heard. On July 17th at 7 a.m., 10 youth and 5 adults from Christ Church departed from Fitchburg, Massachusetts en route to Lyons, New York. Upon arrival in New York, the week of doing God's work had begun. Kids were put into groups of 6 or 7 strangers from all around the country that they would be working with for the week. These groups are called crews. In just one short week, crews start off as groups of unfamiliar strangers, but go home as tight-knit, connected families.
Imagine this, I get a phone call from Regis. It says, do you want to be a millionaire? They put me on the show and I win with 2 lifelines to spare. And I picture this, I act like nothing ever happened. And bury all the money in a coffee can. Well, I've been given more than Regis ever gave away. I was a dead man who was called to come out of my grave. And I think it's time for making some noise. Awake the neighbors, get the word out. Come on, crank up the music, fire the mountain is out. This is life we've been given, made to be lived out. So la la la.
There are about 70 crews that work on projects such as building decks, constructing wheelchair ramps, or painting houses.
After it soared up in the sky, get the sun a cloudless day and tell it not to shine. The thing about this,
if we really have been given the gift of a life that will never end. And if we have been filled with living hope, we're gonna overflow. And if God's love is burning in our hearts, we're gonna blow. There's just no way to keep it in. Awake the neighbors, get the word out.
Site is the home of a citizen of the town that the kids are housed in. The homeowners, or residents, are people whose homes are in need of repairs but are physically or financially unable to complete them on their own. One of the most important connections formed throughout the week is that between the camper and the resident. Each often plays a major role in revealing God's love to the other.
Wake the night.
On normal days, that is, Monday through Friday, crews work on their projects from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. However, on Wednesday, the work ends at 12:30 and youth groups are given the opportunity for some relaxation, fun, and group bonding. This year, the Christchurch Youth Group took a cruise on the Erie Canal.
Sinner's restless heart, you lead us by still waters and to mercy, and nothing can keep us apart. So remember your people, remember your children.
programs are a fun, hands-on worship experience featuring singing, dancing, games, scripture readings, slideshows, and reflective time with God. Devotions are a quieter form of worship. Both daily crew devotions and nightly youth group devotions provide time for youth and adults to share personal stories and God sightings, learn more about God from experiences and each other, and spend time in prayer.
This is the 2011 Christchurch Youth Group Mission Trip Team, fresh off of their return from the village, and I really mean the village, of Lyons, New York. It's surrounded by corn.
I saw God through the works of the residents of Lyons.
Wacky songs varying from Rebecca Black's Friday.
Gotta get down on Friday.
Becoming so close, so fast, with not only people from states across the country, but also with God.
My favorite part about work camp would just be all the love that you're constantly surrounded in.
My favorite part.
My favorite part about mission was meeting my resident.
Into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise.
I really enjoyed meeting new friends because when you would go with your crew, they'd match you with total strangers from like different places, so you would have no idea who you're with, and you have to spend a full week with them. And it's really like a really good bonding experience.
Watching God work and watching Him just touch people.
My favorite part about work camp was making new friends from across the state and from Canada, and then staying connected with God.
Just having God being able to work through you just makes you happy and makes the week of sleeping on an air mattress in unbearable heat worth it.
he said, "You guys have been a family to me this week. You guys showed me God. You are worthy, and you are a child of God."
And I was so humbled by how quickly and willingly these teenagers ran to that cross, and they bowed down.
Watching 405 kids singing, dancing in unbearable heat. Also, you can scan the audience, and you know who the jock was, you know who the tough kid was at school. All those personas were gone. They're able to be who they want to be with Christ. And it's amazing to sit there and watch this transposition happen in their lives.
What does God want me to do next? What does God want me to do?
I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who remain in me, and I in them, will produce much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. This is the 2011 Christchurch Youth Mission Trip. We would like to thank the Christchurch community for participating in our fundraisers and supporting us every step of the way. We couldn't have done it without you. Our parents for helping us prepare for the trip, encouraging us in all our endeavors, and nurturing us in our faith walks. We're your number one fans. Our adult leaders for mentoring us, sharing God's good news with us, and being patient with our craziness all year and on the trip. You're the best. Our youth participants, for their willingness to serve others and the Lord in Christ's name. And most importantly, our Heavenly Father, for making all of this, every last bit of this trip, possible, and for changing the lives of all of those involved.